Personal rules are basically what? Discipline to a certain extent, being disciplined enough to follow your own rules that you impose upon yourself to others. These rules may be a simple thing as coming to work on time, dressing the role accordingly, following certain requests or certain policies that we impose in the office. So these are simple things that one way or the other can institute a certain level of discipline on one's behavior. Rules, of course, are important because they set the standards as to how an office works or how a profession should work. One of my personal rules that I like to follow is that of being prompt, is that of being on time. I would like to pride myself of being one that is a stickler to the time that is given. If there is a meeting at 3 o'clock, I ensure myself to be there at 3. So these are simple things that one should religiously adhere to, or else, you know, if you break your own rules, then it further allows other rules to be eventually broken as well. These may be simple guidelines that one follows, but then these simple guidelines as well are those that are important, because the simple ones are those that are fairly difficult to follow because of their simplicity. You know, the simple thing as coming on time, for a lot of people, they say, yeah, you know, I'll be there on time, but actually they will be late. So the simple thing as wearing something as part of a uniform, they'll probably say, yeah, you know, I'll wear it, but then they normally would want to break it because it is a personality trait that is being questioned. So rules are there because it sets certain standards, it sets certain disciplinary actions that establishes one as a professional. Now, of course, along the way, there will be other rules that can be established, like, say, rules of being up to date, of being current, of making yourself relevant by reading, by experiencing, by always exploring other possibilities, so that at the end of the day, you will not be caught red-handed by not knowing. You know, as one gets older, and that's a fault in my part to a certain extent, that I don't anymore explore other aspects and other facets of life simply because of probably aging. There was a time wherein, at my younger age, I would probably explore the nightlife of the city and seeing the latest bars and the latest hangout places, and to a certain extent utilize that as an experience for further designing. So in short, it's sort of like knowing what the competition or the competitor is up to, and therefore being able to adjust your own personal designs to not necessarily be a copycat. But as one gets older, you tend to slow down a bit, and you tend to take for granted the fact that there is a competition out there, and as resulting now in one being a little bit behind the scenes, so to speak. So these are things that I normally try to promote now to the younger generation by making them a little bit more relevant, by forcing them to go to places and experiencing things, so that they can then fill in the gaps that I may not necessarily be able to fill in, brought about by probably changes of taste, or basically I'm slowing down. Rules to break usually occur as the time warrants it. Now, what do I mean by that? One has to be amenable. One has to be adjustable to things happening around you. One cannot just simply be a stickler to the rules because you want to, when the situation doesn't call for it. A good designer and a good architect and a good leader knows when to adjust along the way. And if that means breaking rules, then that is a means of addressing situations at a very quick manner. So rules are always meant, are there to be followed, but at the same time, rules are also meant to be broken, because broken rules sometimes result in better solutions.